On September 1st, 2022, Japanese and American scientists published an amazing success. For the first time in the universe history, a temperature 3 billion times colder than the interstellar space could be achieved. Join us in this episode of Sci F3 and find out why the news of this discovery has spread everywhere. Sci F3, Episode 7. The achieved supercooling announced means reaching a temperature just 0.0000001 degree above absolute zero, or -273.1499999991 Celsius. Wait, what did you say? -273.1499? Only? What's the problem in reaching almost -273.15 Celsius? Liquid air is -196 Celsius. Near outer space is already -270.45 Celsius. Is it such a problem to cool another 2.7 degrees? In fact, yes. It is not only a problem, it is also against physics laws. Why we can heat things to millions of degrees while we can cool only above -273.15 Celsius, or absolute zero? To understand this, we need first to understand what is temperature and what causes its change. All matter that we know is made of atoms, and atoms are moving and vibrating all the time, so they have kinetic energy. The average of the kinetic energy of the atoms is measured as the temperature. So the more atoms vibrate, the higher the temperature will be, and vis-a-vis, a less atom vibration means lower temperature. This explains absence of an upper level for the temperature. At the Sun core, for example, temperature is 15 million Celsius. And at the early universe, temperature was much, much higher. At the end of the first 100 seconds of the universe age, temperature was 1 billion degree. And at the end of the first second of the universe age, temperature was 10 billion degree, 660 times hotter than the Sun core. And at the first tenth of trillions of the first second, temperature was 5.5 trillion degrees. This temperature never existed again in the universe until it was reached in CERN Large Hadron Collider when lead nuclei were smashed together at near the speed of light. In all the amazingly high temperatures mentioned before, the more temperature we reach, the more atoms vibration we have. In these high temperatures, the atom breaks into its elementary particles, which vibrate as well, reflecting the increased kinetic energy. But on the other hand, when we cool atoms, they start to slow down their vibration, till a point where the vibration stops completely. At this point, all kinetic energy has been taken from the atoms, and there is nothing more to be taken. This point was found to be at -273.15 Celsius, and we called it the absolute zero temperature. How we found it? According to Charles' law of gases, when the pressure is constant, the gas volume reduces proportional to its temperature. By taking several volume and temperature readings for different gases at different pressures, all experiments chart lines extensions met the horizontal axis at one temperature, -273.15 Celsius. Reaching the horizontal axis means the volume shrinked to zero, which is physically not possible. We can just get near to it, but never absolutely reach it. That's why reaching as close as a billionth degree above it is a remarkable achievement in many ways. Let's begin with the amazing technique they used to achieve it. The challenge in cooling is that you always need a colder media to take away heat from the target object. The same happens in the fridge. It is colder than the food, so it can take heat from the hotter food and bring its temperature down. This put us in a dilemma. We have to reach -273.15 degree first to cool anything to the same degree. It was an impossible loop. In 1975, physicists started developing a technique using laser beams directed from six directions on a limited number of atoms at a calculated frequency to slow them down and reach temperatures just above absolute zero. In 1978, researchers cooled ions somewhat below -233 Celsius or 40 Kelvin. In 10 years, they could make it a million times colder and reach 43 microkelvin. They used the same basic principle. Use the force of laser light applied to atoms from six directions to slow them down. These techniques won the Nobel Prize in 1997. The work led to the creation of the quantum state of matter called Bose-Einstein condensate, predicted in 1924 by Albert Einstein on the basis of the quantum formulations of the Indian physicists Satyendra Nath Bose. In this extremely cold state, atoms start to act together as one single atom. This phenomena allowed us to observe directly for the first time quantum behaviors like the wave function on a macro visible scale. Achieving such cold temperature shall allow us to improve the accuracy of the atomic clocks on the GPS satellites and achieve accuracies 100,000 times better than what is found on GPS satellites now. With accuracy at the level of ±10⁻¹⁸, or a trillionth, millionth of a second, two such clocks started running when the universe began 13.8 billion years ago, they would have by now 1 second difference only. This shall bring the GPS accuracy within 1 centimeter rather than the common 10 meters we have now. The more cooling we achieve, the more bizarre materials behave. We see ideal liquids with zero viscosity climbing up its container sides and even penetrating through it. If we stir them to make a vortex, the vortex will run forever. Also a fountain will run non-stop. We get also superconductors with zero resistance to electric current, leading to supermagnets spinning forever. Extreme cooling is used in our largest science projects. Large Hadron Collider main magnets are cooled down to -271.3 Celsius to confine the proton's beam into a focus of 3.5 micron width. Quantum computing require cooling to -273.13 Celsius to perform 158 million times faster than our latest supercomputers. All these applications and more are benefiting from the breakthroughs we are making in cooling. The wonders of what we can achieve with it are not all revealed yet. and the horizons are widening every day. I hope you enjoyed this glimpse into the extreme cooling world, and see you next episode.